يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we thank Him. And we turn to help to Him for help and assistance. Whomever He guides, nobody can misguide. And whomever He leaves astray, nobody can show guidance. Oh Allah, show us all guidance, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. Oh Allah, gather us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the prophets and messengers of yours. As we believed in all of them, even though we did not see them, Allahumma ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. It's February 14th. It's Valentine's Day. It's Eid al-Hub. وَمَنْ مِنَّا لَمْ تَبْلُغْهُ الدَّعْوَةِ وَمَنْ مِنَّا لَمْ يُحِبْ. فكما يقول ابن القيم، بالمحبة وللمحبة قامت السماوات والأرض. Talking about Valentine's Day, talking about red color and hearts and arrows and Cupid and all of that, it is the reality. It is what it is. And why do we talk about it in here? It's a day that millions, maybe billions of people around the world, they celebrate it somehow, they recognize it somehow. يحتفل به الناس من كل أنحاء الدنيا. Like, but the thing is that we Muslims, we kind of tend to have our own look at things. We tend to, or we are meant to kind of lead. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر. We're supposed to lead. We're supposed to be followed. We're not meant as an ummah to follow other nations. We follow. But we follow the Creator. We follow the one who should be followed. And we follow the one He sent Him. And we follow His message. We don't follow other peoples like us. We are actually meant to be followed, to be leaders. Well, this is a very important point that if we understand it, it will make all the difference in our life. It will probably kind of shape our understanding and our mentality and our concept about Islam in general. It will change it completely. It will change it from being a concept of set of rules that you have to abide by, set of rituals that you go by, that you do sometimes or most of the time or all the time. It will change it into a concept of life, a style of life, a concept of way to go, a concept of goodness that you follow and you adopt and you take and you carry to people. So كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. They are meant to liberate people. جئنا لنخرج العباد من عبادة العباد. This is according to the this is the exact sentence of one of the followers of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We came out, we've been sent out to take people out of any kind of servitude to each other into the ultimate freedom and liberation of being under Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and being for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Back to Valentine's Day, some history about it. How did it start? Nothing is confirmed as far as that, but I try my best to refer to some authentic sources. I refer to the Catholic Encyclopedia. I refer to Encyclopedia Britannica. I refer to Wikipedia, even though it's not as authentic as the first two. And three of them, the total of the narrations that they are talking about, الرواية المشهورة عند الثلاثة يعني that Valentine is a kind of a monk. He was a Christian person, and he was a monk who dedicated his life for monasticism and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala كراهب يعني من الرهبان. And that was in the beginning of Christianity, around close to 300 years, less than 300 years after the Jesus عليه السلام سيدنا المسيح أتى بالنصرانية. And what happened is at the time of one of the king Romans, Claudius II, he made it illegal for soldiers to get married. They cannot get married. If soldiers will get married, they will be connected to families, to wives, to children, and they will not be focused in war. So he came up with the idea that any soldier, you know, all soldiers should not get married. It's illegal. But this guy, Valentine, he was just a regular Christian, or a little bit above average, if you would call monks, like a good Christian. He believed otherwise. He was trying to help the soldiers. He was trying to make weddings for them, trying to get them married. And that was obviously against the law that the king passed. They came to know about this. It's a crime. And he was put in prison. And in prison, he fell in love with the daughter of the keeper, the prisoner. And he ended up, you know, being offered to stop doing that and stop even being Christian and follow the Romans, the Roman gods, and support the country then. And he would be given this afu, he would be forgiven, he would be taken out of prison. He refused. He stood up for Christianity and he didn't want to give it up. And he was executed after that. He was executed. And his execution happened to be on the 14th of February 2017 CE. And some years after that, actually many years after that, Christianity ruled and becomes like the predominant religion for this area. And they started remembering this day, or remembering, they call him a martyr, and they even give him the title of a saint, Qaddis Valentine. And he become an icon for love. And then so many things have been added. From that time on, they started taking this day as a day of love, a day of lovers getting together, a day of showing love to each other, and so on. Many things down the history were added to it, like this Cuban thing, the little boy or the little person that with wings that has an arrow and the shape of heart somehow that's getting through it. And actually, we use this many times. But I challenge you that how many of us would know what does this refer to? It refers to the God of love in the Roman style of gods. It's not even love in the sense of love in general. It's the kind of erotic love. It's the God of desire, according to one another encyclopedia, the God of desire, the God of love. This little boy with wings and shape of heart and the arrow getting through the heart. So actually, we tend to do a lot of things and follow a lot of things, whether we believe in it or not, but we do it somehow. Or it's been done widely by everybody, including Muslims, without getting deep into what does this mean or what does this refer to. You're talking about a god, something or some shape or some logo that was used by some people to refer to some kind of god. But what do we believe in as Muslims? We believe it's only one God. Come on. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We don't believe in goddesses and goddesses and God of love, God of desire, God of war. We believe in one God. That is the very core of Islam. That's one thing to just keep it as we're talking about it. The other thing is what kind of love that it is referring to or is highlighting. It's mostly the kind of love that is, you know, boys and girls, lovers, and mostly it's believed on mostly by young people, adolescents, teenagers and stuff. And it's going to be the kind of love that's not very much approved by Islam. Because Islam does approve of love. It's obviously Islam will have some kind of issues with the Valentine Day in a way or another. Whether you agree with it or disagree with it, whether you take it or not take it. But it looks like it doesn't go well with Islam. But why does it not go well with Islam? Is it because of law, the idea of law that has been commemorated or being remembered in that day? No. Because love, Islam, there is nothing, I assume, there is nothing, no religion like Islam that came with love. Is love in Islam is a way for Jannah. لَن تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ. You will not make it to Jannah. That's the Prophet ﷺ is saying. حَتَّى تَحَابُوا. Until you love each other. لَن تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى. Without love, you will not make it to Jannah. It's not my words. The words of the Nabi ﷺ, the one chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولن أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم أفشوا السلام بينكم. لن تدخلوا الجنة حتى تؤمنوا ولن تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. فلا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم أفشوا السلام بينكم. He's talking about not being able to get to Jannah without love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قل المتحابون بجلالي على منابر من نور. They will be in pulpits of light. Who are those? They will be in a status and position that prophets and messengers will even envy them for. Who are those? It is those who love each other for the sake of Allah. What kind of love you're talking about? It's the kind of love that Anas radiallahu anhu one day talking to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he's saying, Ya Rasulullah, met a sa'a. Somebody asked him, what is sa'a? What is the day of judgment? He said, what did you prepare for it? He said, well, I didn't prepare much for the day of judgment. But actually, what I have is that I love Allah and His Messenger. I love Abu Bakr and I love Umar. And he said, well, al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. You will be with the one that you loved. So it is this kind of love that would really take you to Al-Jannah. It is the kind of love that a boy texting a girl texting back a boy, and getting together in the Facebook and sharing some roses and some cards and some words behind, in the back of others or behind them, they would not be very happy if others would get to know about that. Is it this kind of love that you're talking, that's desire, and it's there, and there is nothing wrong with it. The wrong thing is that you explain it or you express it in the wrong way, to the wrong person, in the wrong time. But Islam would not suppress the desire. It's there. You have to respect it and you have to deal with it for what it is. For the right person, when you get married, you will get all the time to express. Actually, you will forget much. And later on, your wife will, you know, you'll have a hard time not remembering that it's Valentine's Day, you didn't get her a greeting card, you didn't get the red flower or something. Well, but you will spend all the time when you were in high school and university thinking about that. So that was probably a delusion or an illusion somehow, in a way or another. So love is there. Love, لا ليس هناك دين يدعو إلى المحبة مثل دين الإسلام. دعا الأبناء إلى حب الآباء والآباء إلى حب أبنائهم. فهل من الحب أن يعق الولد أباه أو أمه؟ Islam called for love between parents and the children, both ways. Islam called to love between husband and wife. If this is the kind of love that you want to talk about, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب عائشة حبا لدرجة أنها تتكلم عن الغيرة ما غيرته. She said, Aisha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she felt kind of jealous so much, badly. She said, I didn't feel this kind of jealousy, even with those wives, other wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even though they were alive, as much as I did to Khadija. Khadija, she passed away, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got married after her. But he was always talking about her. He was always showing his love for her in a way or another, being good to her friends, remembering her memories and stuff. So much so that Aisha, she felt jealous. And with Aisha radiallahu anha, the Prophet would show the extreme kind of love by being so nice and so kind, even with those touches that we will recognize as the only way of love. He would drink from the cup that Aisha radiallahu anha drank from the same spot. He would get the cup after she drank from it, and he would turn it around to the very spot that she drank from, and he would drink from it. To the very last minute of his life, مضغت سواك فأخذه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أعجبه حتى لم يتكلم أحس بحبها له عليه الصلاة والسلام ورضي الله عنها أنه يريد هذا السواك. أخذ السواك منها حتى يكون يعني آخر شيء مس ريقها. يعني what kind of love that you're looking for? النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is talking about a source. ما لكم لا تصلون عليه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم. A source of love that could be between the husband and wife, that so much so that he would put اللقمة يضعها في امرأته. The food that he would take it very nicely and very romantically, and he would put it in the mouth of his wife, and vice versa. What is it? What is the Prophet I'm talking about? He's thinking that this is going to give you reward, صدقة. It's an act of charity. So love is there, وليس في الإسلام وليس في الأديان كلها. دين دعا إلى المحبة وإلى التسامح وإلى الحب وإلى إفشاء السلام وإفشاء كذا في المجتمعات مثل ما دعا إليه الإسلام. لكن ماذا يبقى لنا من ديننا؟ ماذا بالله عليكم؟ حديث عقلي. I'm talking you know logically now, ماذا بقي لنا من ديننا إذا كانت الجنائز يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنا أقدم الحديث وأبني عليه يقول لتتبعن سنن من كان قبلكم الرواية الأشهر أو الضبط الأشهر سنن وليس سنن من كان قبلكم شبرا بشبر وذراعا بذراع في الرواية الأخرى حذو القذة بالقذة حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لدخلتموه وراءهم جحر الضب معروف أنه من أنثى الأماكن رائحة وأقذرها The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said you will follow the ways of the people before you A hand span for hand span, an arm span for arm span, even if they will get into the hole of a lizard, you will get behind them. A hole of a lizard is something like nasty to smell, especially for this kind of dog. But you will follow others, the time will come that you will follow others in everything, even if they get, metaphorically, they get into a hole of a lizard. So, is that this time? ماذا يبقى لنا من الدين؟ أقول ماذا يبقى لنا من الدين إذا كانت الجنائز يعني نقلد فيها غيرنا الصلوات يعني ربما لا نستعلن بها وكذا إذا كان في أعيادنا وقد أبدلنا الله عز وجل بخير الأعياد اليوم يوم عيد اليوم يوم جمعة ينسى الناس أنه يوم عيد المسلمين ويذكرون الأعياد الأخرى ماذا يبقى لنا من الدين إذا كانت الزواج وقضايا الزواج وكذا نقلد فيه غيرنا إذا كانت طرائق الحياة وسبل الحياة في المأكل والمشرب والمطعم والمركب والعمل والسيارات وكذا نقلد فيه غيرنا ماذا يبقى لنا من الدين؟ ماذا يبقى لنا من الدين؟ هل الدين حتى في العقائد وهذا شيء له تعلق بالعقيدة حتى في العقيدة So what I'm saying is what's going to be left for us as far as deen to lead others with If we're going to follow them in everything whatever they could be doing النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم himself is You know, he is implementing this ayah, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينَ You have your way, I have my way as far as religion. But it doesn't mean that he hates them. No. آكل اليهود والنصارى. ساكن اليهود. عايشهم. تعامل معهم. باع منهم. واشترى منهم. بل تزوج. صفية ما كانت إلا يهودية وأسلمت. وأحل الزواج للمسلمين من النصارى ومن اليهود. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is living with Jews, eating with them, inviting them. Most of the business was done with them, living with them, having treaties with them. It's not about that. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ You have your way, I have my way. It's not that we become enemies just by definition. No. But you have your way. وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا هُمْ نَاسِكُوا فَلَا يُنَازِعُنَّكَ فِي الْأَمْرِ Every nation, Allah said, every nation, they have their own mansak. Mansak could mean in a way or another a day or a celebration day somehow. We're talking about the religious significance, the things that have some kind of religious significance, not any kind of day to be celebrated because if it's national or something that's, it's not related to faith, it's fine. Simply, you know, it's fine. But when it comes to faith, we have our faith, that we have faith in, that we believe in, that we don't follow gods and other gods other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not commemorate any days based on anything just like that. So أيها الأكارم إن يعني it's not because of love that love is bad or something. No love, the right love is actually as I explained is there in Islam. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is practicing it to the utmost. And Muslims are loving each other and those who love each other يظلهم الله في ظل رجلان تحابا في الله اجتمع عليه وتفرق عليه. يعني what else that we need to show that Islam is kind of recognizing love. Those two people who love each other for the sake of Allah, they will be in the shade, under the shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's not only that they show love. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, إِذَا أَحَبَّ الرَّجُلُ أَخَاهُ When you love another Muslim, let them know. Let them know. فَلْيُخْبِرُهُ Let him, tell him, you have to tell him that I love you. And the other person would say, أَحَبَّكَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَحْبَبْتَنِي فِيهِ المسلم يحب المسلمين رجالهم ونساءهم يحب المؤمنات حب الدين يدافع عنهن يصون عرضهن لا يعني يخوض فيهن بنظره وبكلامه وبلسانه هذا الحب هذا هو الحب الحقيقي loving of the Muslim community loving goodness for all is to have some action is to respect if you talk about females strangers who are not yours it's not your mothers you show them love in what way in feeling the sense of community to them in caring for them loving for them what you love for your sister or loving for them what you love for your wife so this is the kind true kind of love, not that kind of love that comes once a year that we will find all the everybody is trying to dress red somehow, and everybody is exchanging flowers and postcards and some words and some actions and some parties and this and that, without really much of action to show the real love. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يحببنا فيه وفي رسله وفي أنبيائه وفي بعضنا وفي إخواننا وفي المسلمين جميعا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الأمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وكل من اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته إلى يوم الدين. أيها الأكارم، we always talk about Islam, and again Islam والله is meant to make our life easier, not to add burdens to it or something. Please move forward, inshallah, if you can move forward, أيها الأخوة, to make room for the brothers who are still coming. Please move forward and to this side of the masjid. JazakAllah khair. So, يعني, if we talk about romance and this kind of love in the sense of romance, actually some I come across two studies, one that was done in Cairo University, Egypt, and one that was done in Syracuse University, upstate New York. And both of them is referring to this kind of romance, love before marriage, two people loving each other. That's not to say it's bad. I mean, the essence of it. But that's the study. You can question that, you can take it, whatever you want to deal with it. That most of these marriages, according to the study of Cairo University, is 88% of those marriages starting this way, actually they have they either failed or faced serious problems, versus those kind of marriage that they call the arranged marriages. So when it comes to even marriage, the marriage that's based on what we call love, which is not love actually, it's attraction. Two people attracted to each other. He is attracted to how she looks, she is attracted to how he speaks and how he's cool and how he's or whatever, talking, speaking, attracting, or even singing or whatever. That's not love, that's attraction. And when this attraction, when you satisfy this attraction, it's probably gonna, and so what? What's, you know, those called like arranged marriages, I'm not here to propagate for arranged marriages or anything, but because two people and actually other outsiders help them study the case, study these two persons, look at whether they are fit to each other, and obviously they have to accept each other, and there's no problem even to love each other, if acceptance is there, and also if the reality, الحياة الواقعية, الكفاءة موجودة, هذا مكافئ له وهي مكافئة له, then, you know, marriage will happen, and most likely, inshallah, it will be successful. So there's no need for youth to waste their time, there's no need for youth to leave this wild kind of desire, mislead them, I'm not going to say lead them, mislead them. It's so hard, especially, and it's so easy in those days, so easy to get into haram things, especially with having phone, that you can have, you can be connected to all the girls of the world and girls to the boys of the world, and getting to all Facebook groups and every kind of thing, getting to all kind of pages and websites and talk whatever you want. But, well, it's not only your parents anymore as it used to be in the past that are looking at you somehow, or you care for them, or you respect them, or you even fear them. It's actually the time that we have to, it's a test for our true faith. Do we have faith in Allah? This is for myself, for everybody. We have to, يعني, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى. Doesn't he know that Allah sees him? Allah is looking at you all the time when you send this text to this girl. Allah knows about, you know, this meeting when you meet with this boy or this girl. This is a message for you. When you highlight, when you give priority to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over your own desire, well, you know how many hadith is there. كَمْ مِنَ الْآيَاتِ كَمْ مِنَ الْحَدِيثِ كَمْ مِنَ الْمَوْعُودَاتِ الَّتِي وَعَدَهَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ لِشَابٍ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ وَلِشَابٍ صَبَرَ وَكَذَا. يعني, a lot of things that you would get when you suppress, when you control this desire. And now the second message is for parents. Let's, you know, take our responsibility as being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us in charge of this family. And for us, from the young age, we have to instill good things in them. And we have to watch them all through, not in the sense of monitoring them, not in the sense of having surveillance, you know, a mentality over them, but to help them and to share our experience with them, and above all, to be aware of what's going on. Many parents, they are not aware of what's going on. And I'm saying that they are not aware, some, at least some, they are not aware of what's going on. There is a lot that's going on whether you know it or whether you don't know it. So you try, you better be aware of what's going on so you can better help your kids, so you can better, provide the good advice or good sharing good experience with them. So, you know, it will, they will pass this kind of period of their life safely, inshallah. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يعصمنا وإياكم من شر الشيطان الرجيم. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يعصمنا من شر أنفسنا وشر الإنس والجن. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all kinds of evil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala direct us to what's the best for us in this dunya and akhirah. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.